When you start over, just take a beat, because that really helps with editing.
Okay. Beat, beat, radish. Welcome back. Last time, we used a cauliflower to show you where the mammalian midbrain reward system is. We used a cauliflower because even though the brain is an incredibly complex organ, the ideas we're talking about are really simple. There's an outside flowery part to the brain, the cortex, which is evolutionarily new. There's a brain stem, which is incredibly evolutionarily old. And then there's that middle part that all mammals, you, me, the dogs, all have in common. We said that that's where we're going to have to look to find Dr. Silkworth's two core phenomena of addiction. Now, just to remind you, those were, first, that someone with addiction, when they take a rewarding substance, gets a physical compulsion and can't stop taking that substance. We're going to call that compulsive use. The second core phenomena was that people with addiction have a difficult time not using because they have a base state in which they feel restless, irritable, and discontented. We said that the answers were going to lie in the mammalian midbrain. And today, we're going to focus down on that to show you why. But first, I need to warn you. We're going to talk about parts of the brain, fancy Latin terms. Don't worry about any of it. None of it is going to need to be remembered. There's no test at the end of the video. So we're going to start by drawing the ventral tegmental area. It's a group of cells, but we're just going to draw one cell body. And then there's the axon. That's the arm of the ventral tegmental area that reaches out to another group of cells and sends the signal. In this case, the ventral tegmental area makes and uses a chemical called dopamine to send a signal to another group of cells called the nucleus accumbens. When you have enough dopamine at the nucleus accumbens, the nucleus accumbens sends another signal off to a part of the cortex that tells your brain everything's fine. We're good down here. We've got enough. Survival's assured. Go ahead and use that thinking part of your brain. Go ahead and focus on things. Read a book. Even read a textbook. Make a plan. Think about the future. If somebody comes up to you on the street and wants a dollar, no problem. If your neighbor needs help building the fence, no problem. You've got enough. You can share. These are all things that we can do when we have enough dopamine. When we don't have enough dopamine, though, it's an entirely different signal. Don't be thinking about the future. Read a textbook. No, burn it for fuel. You're probably freezing to death. It is a survival signal to focus right here, right now, on you to fix this problem. So this low dopamine signal, which we're going to call dopamine tone, this low dopamine tone creates behavior in us as a way of trying to fix the problem. We're restlessly looking around for the fix to the situation. Maybe it's heat, maybe it's more food, maybe it's shelter. We're quite irritable with anything that distracts us from that search. And if we do find something from outside that maybe doesn't fix the problem permanently, but makes us feel better temporarily, like a drug, it only lasts a little while. So we can never stay contented. Low dopamine tone at the nucleus accumbens, that's the core of restless, irritable, and discontented. You've all felt this, or at least a bit of it. Maybe you went too long without food. Maybe you really were stuck in the cold. Maybe your life really was in danger. Or maybe you were just hangry after too much birthday cake. You felt it a little bit, but people with addiction feel this low dopamine tone 24/7. But why do they feel that way? Well, for that, we're going to have to explain a few more things about the nature of dopamine and its signal at the nucleus accumbens. And we'll get into that next time. I hope you join me. Until then, be well.